Top, no, the big one.
Ladies and gentlemen, our next contest of the evening will be fought in the Super Fight Series under 82 kilogram category. And is sponsored by Bespoke Building Design. Please welcome the first fighter making his way to the blue corner, Bartosz. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the second fighter making his way to the red corner, Marc, the freaking Rican Navarro!
Merchant ships, minutes after day to die from the bottomless pit. But my hand was made strong by the end of the Almighty. We forward in this generation triumphantly. Won't you help to sing these songs of freedom? 'Cause all I ever had, redemption songs, redemption songs.
Introducing these two Super Fight Series warriors once again, the fighter standing in the blue corner. He weighed in at 81 kilograms and has a record of 2 wins with 3 losses. He represents the Warrior Fight Club from Poland, Bartosz! And standing across the ring in the red corner, this fighter weighed in at 80.7 kilograms. He has a fight record of 8 wins with 4 losses and represents Navarro Fitness and Fighting Gym from Costa Rica via Scotland. He is Marc the freaking Rican Navarro.
Yeah, perfect. Yep. It's we just don't need you in our ear. We can see it coming up. It's much easier. Thanks, though.
Chris, three-minute rounds in this super fight, and we talk about international bouts. We have a Polish fighter against a Scottish Costa Rican.
Cannot wait for this one. Bartosz, Franik, really skillful, but he's taking on a guy in the freaking Rican who has a significant edge in experience.
Oh!
Expect Franik to try to stay mobile, use a speed advantage, and avoid the power shots of Marc Navarro.
Yes, the other thing he's got to use is that height and reach advantage, you said rightly, and not get carried away. Keep his man at bay, as he's trying to do here now. Because as you said, the experience advantage, and you feel the power is with Navarro.
Franik is doing the correct thing, covering, trying to get his head to avoid those shots, but he eats a ripping blow to the breadbasket. This could be over, Malcolm.
Now, Chris Batchelder is going to be talking about this, because after the knockdown, there was the knee
out of our
to the thigh of the downed opponent of Franik. So we're going to see whether, I think Chris is going to have a word with Navarro now. No knockdown because of the follow-up strike, I'm telling you, Chris.
Wow, that was a huge, costly mistake. That was a brilliant shot, beautiful timing, but spoiled by that foul play.
Navarro threw after his man was on the canvas, and now he takes a round kick to the face from Bartosz. Franik back in this.
Looking to cry and rocking with that knee. Gotta watch out for excessive clinching, though.
Well, both men now have been fired up by that incident, Chris, and Franik looked for the big knee as well. And Navarro looking for those heavy shots once more, and this has suddenly come to life because of that incident.
Nice connection here again.
Franik knocks up on Navarro! He's up on his feet, but just as Navarro made the connection, Franik, the round kick. Navarro is telling Chris Batchelor, Chris, he's okay, and unbelievably, he's back. This is the Super Fight Series.
I cannot believe what I have just seen. Down went Navarro, but like a bouncing ball, he was back to his feet. I think that was definitely a knockdown. I think the fact that when he hit the mat woke him up.
You can have what we call in the game flash knockouts, Chris, and that was it. But you know why he got back up? Because he's the freaking Rican, man.
Franik looking to try and connect again with that knee. Navarro able to slip. Good coverage here from both guys in the clinch, but it's the moment when they disconnect that you gotta watch out. Navarro loses his head right under that head kick. Franik is gonna look for it again.
Well, he did that because he was doing so well with the body shots that you mentioned, because he was looking to work Franik's body again, and that's when he came in with a devastating kick.
Excessive clinching again there from Franik. Bartosz has gotta watch out. Under Kingdom rules here, you're not allowed the same liberties that you would be given in one time.
But again, as you can see, what I love about this, Chris, is we're seeing right in front of our commentary position the difference in styles between these two men. The rolling, brawling style, and he gets caught again. Navarro, I was just about to say the way he rolls, but running with the knee as well, and I think this spectacle. Oh, I thought we were going to get a count there, Chris.
Yeah, he was actually looking to try and watch out and make sure he broke him from the clinch. Gotta watch out for those moments in transition. This fight is all about those entrances and exits in full swing. Both guys obviously really hurting each other. 2 points. That was an unbelievable connection there from Navarro to start things off. Spoiled by that low blow. And then Franik came back in spades.
Well, the thing was, Chris, it was a remarkable round. Look, Franik came back, and both men, as you said, the thing about this was the punishment they both take. Potential knockouts both ways. There's the knee coming in, and Chris actually splits them there after that knee. Unbelievable stuff from these two.
The action really rolled into some incredible sequences here. Let's take a look at that knockdown here in a second. Really curious to see how this one went. Let's try to give us an angle on it.
And there's the stars I was on about, though, Chris, with the way that Navarro likes to come in with those heavy body shots, but it does open him up for the big kicks.
Well, the next round here on tap tonight. That was a breathtaking 3 minutes, Malcolm.
Well, either man you felt could have been out there, and now they both believe, this is the thing about this fight, Chris, they both believe they have the skill set to end this. Franik with the knees and the legs, Navarro with the boxing.
Franik's got to be very careful when he dips his head. Sometimes he dips his head in and out of combinations, keeps him open. And of course, less aware of what might be coming his way. That being said, Navarro actually leaned into that head kick.
Chris, let's be blunt. These are two reckless fighters, and that's what's making this bout so good. Franik just wants to get in there and use those long legs to either kick his opponent or knee him. Navarro wants to close that gap and hit the bombs with the boxing, and neither cares what they take to get there. That's why this is exciting. There you go.
Fighting like a man possessed here. Bartosz Franik has got to be very careful. Sometimes he beats with his face. Fighting with your forehead is not a smart thing when you're trading blows like this.
Chris, let me tell you now, careful is not in either of these men's dictionaries. We've seen that across these two rounds. It's great advice. I just don't think either man is going to listen to it.
Excessive clinching here. Navarro bleeding profusely. Looks for the sweep. It won't score, but it's still a legal technique. Unbelievable again, Chris. The Super Fight series, the masterpiece, and these two men, non-stop action. And as I said, it's for one simple reason. They both believe genuinely they can stop their opponent. Nice uppercut there from Navarro. Mark Navarro is using some good dirty boxing. That's why Franik needs to be careful here at close range and duck like that. Sometimes it's smart when you're boxing, you actually dip ahead and deflect those incoming shots at the crown of your head rather than taking the flush. But when you're in danger of getting boxed up on the inside, i.e. the uppercut, you gotta be careful.
And there's the roll, Tyson style, from Navarro. And you alluded to them earlier, those vicious body shots from the Scottish Costa Rican fighter. Oh, is that, he's saying that's to the groin. And Chris Patrick was saying, no, it's not. More controversy in this bout, Chris. We've had it all here. And there, that looks slightly low again.
Bartosz, Franik is in trouble here. Out goes the mouthpiece.
That's
Navarro's mouthpiece is out, Malcolm.
Yes, it is. And look at them and listen to the crowd respond. That's low. That was low again. Now that one, Navarro has landed twice. Blindside of Chris Patchell, to be fair. Blindside of the referee. He's cleverly landed the two low blows here. And Franik's taken them and come back. This is crazy, Chris.
Both men are crimson red. And there is chaos tonight in center ring. They are on their feet here at the Albans Arena, Malcolm, for good reason.
Unbelievable stuff, Chris. And look at this. The contrasting styles have gelled perfectly for us. Both men, incredible self-belief with regards to their power to stop the other man. And the other man just doesn't understand that. Chris, breathtaking.
I still can't believe we're actually here with both men on their feet at the amount of heavy leather and TNT being exchanged. Well, let's take a look at some of the action here. It was really a fight in a phone booth through and through. But for me, the big difference was some of the dirty boxing on the inside. Both guys landed some good shots. Here we see some nice work from Navarro, and then of course those knees, a couple of dirty uppercuts, and that was a low blow. Tough to see whether or not that was legal from the angle. Though.
That was one of three, Chris. You talked about dirty boxing. That one, we could give him the benefit of the doubt. The other two, blindside of Chris Batchelor, definitely landed. But as you saw, the reason Franik was willing to take those was to try and drive that knee into the face of his opponent. We've got two reckless men here throwing caution to the wind and giving us such entertainment. And we've still got another round.
Nice low kick there from Franik. I want to see him back off and use his range. That was the most intriguing thing that we saw in the first round. But really, he didn't choose to utilize. I would have expected him to use his physical advantages with more intelligence.
And picking up on something you said in round two there, Chris, already, Navarro's thrown the uppercut that you alluded to that could finish this.
These guys are throwing everything to knock you out. Beautiful front kick there. Lands from Franik, out goes the mouthpiece. It went flying out of the ring.
Chris, have you ever seen two skill sets gelled so superbly for entertainment purposes?
I've never seen anything like this in my life. I've called over 1,000 fights, and I've never seen two guys stand here almost as if they were boxing on ice skates and throw hell for leather with every single punch and kick.
And it's the contrasting techniques that I love. There's the low blow again from Navarro, and Franik shrugs it off and comes in again. I agree with you wholeheartedly about the way he brings that head down. If one clean uppercut from Navarro can get there, he could take it clean off. But these two men, full credit, the roof will be raised if they both reach the end of this incredible round.
Well, it's reached boiling point here, and also exhaustion. Navarro and Franik are gassed. Navarro actually looks more fresher, finer right now.
They always say, if you're gonna leave it in the ring. There's your proof here, these two, unbelievable. And Navarro taking these knees, eating these knees, Chris, but he's still coming forward. Look at this. This is pure instinct from both men.
Franik trying to do what he can to cover up here. That was a nice uppercut again from Navarro to a left hook. He needs to continue to finish his combinations with that left hook. Franik was open to it.
They're not worried about their heads. They're not worried if they clash. They're not worried about moving them. Franik knows if he throws the knee up, Navarro's head's going to be there. Navarro knows exactly where Franik's going to be, and this time it's Franik with the uppercut, Chris.
Navarro just landed another good right uppercut, though. I want to see him finish with that left hook. Loaded up. When the right comes in, he's torque up that punch.
And here they go again, covered in blood, bathed in blood for you. Incredible durability and heart from these two men. Oh, and the right knee again, Chris, and Navarro had to stop. Did he really take that? What a chin of that man.
It is jaw-dropping stuff here. Both men on autopilot just continuing to try and knock each other senseless. Nice knee again there from Franik. This could be huge, this could steal the round now.
Chris has landed three in a row, and Navarro still pouring at him as they're pulled apart. Three clean knees to end that round. Chris, let's put it in the perspective here. Whoever loses this, I will personally feel gutted for them after performing from both men like that. It will be heartbreaking.
Well, you said in the third round, Malcolm, you got to go out there and you have to leave everything in the ring. And both Franik and Navarro did exactly that. Let's take a look at how this all went down. Here we go, some of the action. You can see some good inside fighting from both guys, but really just in full tilt. Punches, knees, kicks.
And Chris, for the full 3 minutes, and I'm talking non-stop, just like this. Look at the punishment. No regard for defense, always going forward the whole time.
You read my mind exactly. There was really no regard for defense whatsoever, and that made for entertaining action here tonight in the Super Fight Series. While the judges' scorecards are in, we'll go to our master of ceremonies, Mr. Grant Waterman, to make it all official.
Ladies and gentlemen, after three incredible rounds of Super Fight Series action,
guys, I'm still
we come to the judges'
scorecards. Can we get rid of that?
And it's
tough to hear each other.
In favor of your winner.
Can you guys hear me or not?
From Poland, Bartosz!
Well, there was a huge last-minute flurry there from Franik. When combined with that knockdown in the first round, tough to say, though, there really could be a loser in this fight, Malcolm. An incredible performance from both Navarro and Franik.
I agree with you, Chris. And if you watch that again, and if that was a movie, people say, yeah, that was brilliant, but that's just the movies. No, that was real here at the Super Fight Series.
Can you guys hear me? I'm on talkback now. For some reason, we're still hearing all the chatter. Is there a way we can get rid of that?